Welcome to another video for presenting actual versus forecasted sales data. In previous video, we have seen steps to create a chart for showing actual sales data, forecasted sales data, and difference between these two in a single chart itself. However, this visual had one limitation: whenever the actual sales were exceeding forecasted sales. Some people were getting confused whether the actual sales is 4,73,000 or total of 4,73,000 plus 1,23,000. Hence, we will be presenting this data using a little different format. Now, here in the current visual, you can clearly see that the actual sales for pista flavors is 4,73,000, forecasted sales is 3,50,000, and thus the difference between these two is 1,23,000, which is getting displayed in green color. Similarly, for chocolate flavor, actual sales is 3,88,000, forecasted sales was 4,51,000, and difference between these two was 64,000, which is shown in red color. Now, instead of showing the actual amount difference, we can also show this in a percentage terms. So here in this visual, you can clearly see that instead of the actual difference amount we are showing for pista flavors, the actual sales have increased or exceeded by forecasted sales by 53%. And similar presentation is being done for other flavors as well. So let us quickly have a look at inside Excel how we can create this chart. So here we have our dummy sales data for forecasted and actual sales. Since we will be creating some additional fields, I will copy this data and paste it over here in blank cells. So let us start with our first formula. This will be base variance. This will be minimum of forecasted and actual sales. Let us press Ctrl Enter. This will be above forecasted. This will be below forecasted. So let us wrap this. And now we will be calculating the difference between actual and variance. So this time actual minus forecasted sales, or else press 0. So wherever there is a difference in negative, it will display a 0 over here. We will do the exact opposite for below forecasted. This time forecasted minus actual sales, or else press 0. So wherever there is a negative number, it is showing 0. Wherever it is positive, it is showing the exact number. So wherever the forecasted sales is greater than actual, it is showing over here. Wherever actual sales is greater than forecasted, it is showing under this column. Now let us select this entire data set. Let us go to insert. We'll be selecting stacked column. So this chart is being created. So let me drag this a little below this. So let us increase the width. Let us go to chart design and switch columns and rows so that our flavors are getting displayed under x-axis. And forecasted and other data is getting displayed under this stacked bar. So let us go to change chart type. We'll be selecting combo and forecasted sales cluster column. Cluster column, I am fine with it. So we'll be selecting this under secondary axis. And for base variance, it will be stacked column. Above forecasted, it will be stacked column. And this one also will be stacked column. So all of these three additional fields which we have created, it will be on primary axis. So let us click OK. And this way it is getting displayed. Just make sure that your primary axis and secondary axis have the minimum values and maximum values exactly identical. So if they are not identical, you can select them, press Ctrl 1. This window will open up and then you can set them with exact same numbers over here if those are not coming same. So once it is set, just press delete. Press delete for primary axis also. And even this horizontal bar lines, we don't want that. So let us select x-axis, go to line. We don't want to show any lines. We'll add our major lines. So let us select them. Let us change the colors. Let us change the width. This will be in dashed one. Now the legend should be on the top. Okay, so let us decrease this a little bit. We'll place the legend properly over here. We'll delete this chart title. We'll copy the chart title from our previous chart. Let us select them. Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Let us adjust our legend also. We don't want this base variance to be displayed. So let us select that and press delete. Now we have only the relevant data getting displayed. So let us change the colors now. Select above forecasted, change the color for above forecasted to green color. Even outline will be in green color. For below forecasted, it will be red color. Outline will also be a red color. Forecasted sales can be in gray color. Outline will also be in gray color. Actual sales will be in blue color. Outline will also be in blue color. So now we want to display our data label, since we don't have y-axis for primary as well as secondary. So let us go to data labels. Let us click that, and immediately you can see the exact numbers in lakhs are getting displayed, which are very large number. So we'll have to do custom formatting in the source data itself. So select that entire data set, press Ctrl 1, and now here hash mark and comma, and let us click OK. So these numbers are now being displayed in 1000. So now let us format this as well. These numbers are related to base variance, so which are displayed over here. We don't want that. So let us press delete. Let us select this. So this will be at the bottom inside base, which will be for actual sales. Similarly for forecasted ones, we want at the bottom. Okay. So now we can change the color for both of these data labels. And now these data labels will have to drag just like this. Select them, drag. This also you will have to drag it. So once you have these data labels getting displayed properly like this, it's easier to understand. Wherever it is above forecasted, this is in green color. Wherever it is below forecasted, it's in red color. Now, we have also seen that instead of actual numbers, we want to display percentage over here. So for that purpose, you will have to create few more columns. This will be calculating percentage, and we will be using those numbers for our data labels. So instead of showing the exact amount. So let me copy this chart and paste it over here. Now let us calculate the percentage over here. So this will be divided by our forecasted sales. This will be in percentage terms. So let us drag this over here. Similarly, we'll do it for below forecasted. Let us drag it over here. This will be in percentage. So now we will be selecting these data labels. Instead of value, we'll be selecting values from sales. This will be from this columns. So let us click OK. So these are getting displayed. Similarly, select this one. This will be values from this particular sales, and let us click OK. So now these numbers are getting displayed. However, there is a 0% also which is getting displayed. So we need to format that. So let us select this, Control 1, let us select percentage, then go to customs, and then press semicolons 3 times, and let us click OK. So this 0 will get hidden in the background. So it won't get deleted. With custom number formatting, those are hidden. So this way you can display, instead of actual numbers, the percentage numbers also. So if it is not getting displayed, you can increase the width also for data labels. So this way it get displayed properly. So that's it like from my side, guys. See you guys in next video for showing this visual in horizontal format instead of vertical format.